Bam, Mr. Taru. Okay, in this video, we're going to remind you, or depending on the class you're in, introduce how to graph a linear inequality in two variables. So, we're going to be solving the inequality for y. We're going to graph the line because that was, you know, that's what a linear function is. It's a line, as if it were an equation. So, when I'm going to do this example here in a second. Even though it says y is less than negative 1/3 x plus 4, we're going to just temporarily, you know, pretend like there's an equal sign there so that we remember how to graph that line or that linear function, in this case using the slope-intercept form. Then we're going to shade and talk about the line structure. Really, 2 and 3 kind of go together because when you graph equations, every graph is a solid line. Well, when you graph inequalities, you may have an equal sign as part of your inequality, or you may not, where it's just greater than or less than. And that means sometimes you have a dotted line and sometimes you don't. So, once you get the y value isolated, the y term isolated, actually not just the y term, you need to get the variable completely alone. So if it's y is greater than, and then the expression will be, you know, like probably y in terms of x, where the right-hand side only has the variable of x in it, then you're going to be looking at a dotted line because there's no equal sign, and you're going to shade up. And that's because it says y is greater than. So your y's get bigger as you go up the y-axis. So you shade up. If it's y is greater than or equal to, then it's going to be a dot, a solid line because of that equal sign. So the line is actually a solution to the inequality, whereas if it's just greater than, the line defines where the solutions begin, but it itself is not part of the solution. And you shade up again because your y values are getting larger. Let me just add this in here. When you have an equal sign as part of your inequality, you want to shade, or you want to have a solid line. And then if it's less than, you shade, you have a dotted line and you shade down because your y values get smaller as you go down the y-axis. And if it's less than or equal to, again with the equal sign, that means that your graph itself is part of the solution set for that graph where you shade is all the points that are solutions to that inequality, and you shade again down. Now, there are directions of how to graph inequalities that involve not getting the y term alone or the y variable completely isolated. You just graph the function or equation, and then you determine where to shade based on doing a test point. If it's a linear function, I prefer getting the y value alone first. However, the video coming up, we're going to be graphing like circles and ellipses, and when you or a just a non linear function. In those cases, you definitely want to have this sort of test point method, which we'll talk about in those videos. At any rate, we are going to isolate the y to graph these linear functions. Now, here I have an equation that's already in slope-intercept form, where it's in the form of y equals mx plus b. And when you have an equation set equal to y, linear function equal to y, the coefficient of x is going to be your slope, which is rise over run, and I like to graph that as either you go up if the slope is positive, or you go down if the slope is negative. That's kind of almost the same color on the camera. Let me change that to blue. And then the bottom, the run value is always to the right. That's how I like to teach slope. Slope is rise over run. That's not uncommon, but when you graph, the top, you know, if the slope is positive, you move up. If the slope is negative, you move down, and you always have that run value going to the right. You know, you read your graph going left to right like you do a textbook, or any book for that matter. And then you have the y-intercept out here, the b value. And when you graph lines that are in slope-intercept form, you want to do the y-intercept first, and the slope second. So I'm going to do three examples and we're going to start picking up the pace here. This has a slope of negative 1/3. So we're going to go down 1 and over 3. We have a y-intercept of 4. And to graph the line, we're just going to go up to the y-value of 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. we're going to do what the slope says, which is go down 1 and over 3. So from the y-intercept, down 1 and over 3. Now, I said graph the line as if it were an equation, but I don't want to just automatically go and just draw a solid line, because it might be dotted. And indeed it is, because its y is less than negative 1/3 x plus 4, not less than or equal to. So this is going to be a dotted line, and y is less than, y's get valued, y values get smaller as you go down. That's my first example. Let's clear off the right-hand side of this board and do two more. Okay, so I hope you like I put on my my best St. Patrick's Day outfit here for you, my bow tie and everything, getting dressed up for our little chalk talk here. We have 3x minus 2y is less than or equal to 10. Now, this equation, this linear function right now is in standard form, and you can graph this using x and y intercepts, where to find the x intercept you let y equal 0, and to find the y intercept you let x equal 0. But if you graph it that way, you have to do a test point to determine where to shade. And again, we're going to do that with the nonlinear function. So we're going to, like the last example, put these into slope-intercept form and get the graphs, which means get the y alone. So how am I going to get this y value by itself? Well, I want to move everything away from it. And you want to do or take care of what's touching that y value last. So we're going to first subtract both sides by 3x. And that'll give us negative 2y is less than or equal to negative 3x plus 10. Now we're going to divide everything by negative 2. And we're also going to need to remember that when you divide by a negative number or multiply both sides of an inequality by a negative number, you need to remember to change the direction of that sign. So we're dividing both sides by negative 2. So because we're doing that division of negative 2 to both sides, and I don't care about being 2, but being negative, that is going to change the direction of our inequality. So we're going to have negative 2 divided by negative 2 is 1, y. Negative divided by negative is positive, and we're going to leave that as 3 over 2. Now, if you're one of those students that hate fractions and you're always making them into decimals, okay, but slope is rise over run, so you do not want to convert that into a decimal. Not that you can't, it's just honestly going to make it harder to graph. If your decimal is like, you know, this would be, well, this isn't going to be a hard one, but 1.5. Well, how are you going to graph a slope of 1.5? You need a rise over a run number, and 1.5, you'd have to place that over 1 and go up 1.5 units and then over 1. So now you're going to be graphing a decimal, which shouldn't be, you know, really difficult, but it's not going to simplify your life any for these type of questions to turn these fractions into decimals. It's not a great habit to do all the time anyway. 10 divided by negative 2 is negative 5, and we have a, let's see here, we have a slope, which is 3 over 2, so we're going to go up and over. We have a y-intercept, which is equal to negative 5. And again, when you put equations in the slope-intercept form, you do the y-intercept first, and then you take care of the slope. So we have a y-intercept of negative 5, so down to 5, negative 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, make a dot. Do what the slope says, which is up 3 and over 2. So 1, 2, 3 from the y-intercept and over 2. We got another point. Is this going to be solid or dotted? It's an equal sign. So that means that the line itself, the linear function, is part of the solutions to this inequality, so the line needs to be solid. Draw that solid line through there. And just for clarity purposes, we're not really crossing the x-axis at exactly 3. That's just my sketching this out by hand. Because if we go up 3 and over 2, and then up 2 and over 1, so, you know, it's a sketch, right? We have y is greater than or equal to, and your y values get greater or larger as you move up the y-axis, so our shading is going to be above that solid line that we just made. Now, what does that mean? It means that any point in the shaded area, and let's just quickly verbally check 0, 0, should be a solution to this inequality. So if I plug in 0, 0, where x is 0 and y is 0, 3 times 0 is 0, minus 2 times 0 is 0, and 0 minus 0 is less than or equal to 10. So indeed, there, you know, just as an even though I said I was going to do the test point stuff later, that's why you shade with inequalities, because all of the points within that shaded area will make that original inequality true. This one, this equation, has quite a bit more work before we're ready to easily graph it. So one reason why I gave you this as an example is because a lot of students, if it's when you have parentheses, at this point you probably have a good idea that if there's some number in front of the parentheses, it needs to be distributed through those parentheses. But here it's just a minus sign, so a lot of students incorrectly will want to take the 4x and multiply it through the parentheses. But that 4x is not what's touching the parentheses. What's touching the parentheses, what's immediately in front of that parentheses that will get multiplied through, is negative 1. So you might want to slip in a 1 there to actually see that number. And we're going to distribute the negative 1 through the parentheses and get y by itself again. So we have 4x, negative 1 times 2 is negative 2y, negative 1 times negative 7 is positive 7, and that's greater than or equal to 3. We're going to, let's move the 7 over to the right hand side with subtraction, and we get 4x, and you get some bigger chalk, minus 2y is greater than or equal to negative 4. We're going to move the 4x to the other side by subtraction. Now this minus sign is for the 2, the negative is for the 2. The 4x is positive, so when you decide what you want to move to the other side of an equation or an equality, always look to its left, not to its right. That's a positive 4x, so we're going to subtract both sides by 4x and get negative 2y is greater than or equal to negative 4x minus 4. Last step, divide everything by 2. And I'm dividing by a negative again. Remember what that means? When you divide by a negative number, you have to remember to change the direction of the inequality. So we're going to have y, because negative 2 by negative 2 is 1, less than or equal to, that's going to be negative 4 divided by negative 2 is 2x, plus 2. So this has a slope of 2 and a y-intercept that is also equal to 2. Without writing it down this time, our y-intercept is equal to 2. Our slope is positive 2. Now, well, this is the first example I've done without a fractional slope in this video, so let me just write this out. When you have a slope, slope is rise over run. So just because this is the first example that we've done where our slope does not look like a fraction, please do not just go up 2 units and draw a point. Slope is rise over run. Slope must be written as a fraction, even if it doesn't appear to be a fraction in your equation, okay? So your slope is going to be up 2 and over 1. So up 2 over 1. Let's draw that solid or dotted. There's an equal sign, so a solid line. The y term is alone, and it's on the left-hand side of the inequality, so we can just read it left to right. Y is less than or equal to 2x plus 2. Your y values get smaller when you shade down. That's your last example. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.